Donc nous voici aux États-Unis. No, I'm joking. La zone. How I became bilingual without any trouble, just by staying in France and by practicing by myself. I'm going to tell you the three tips that really helped me, and I hope that these tips will also help you master English and become the bilingual that you are able to become. Ouch. Welcome to It's English, the place where you learn English through storytelling. Dans cette chaîne, le but c'est d'apprendre l'anglais facilement au travers du storytelling. Le storytelling qui est une technique qui nous permet d'apprendre au travers d'histoires tout simplement. Et donc aujourd'hui, je vais vous raconter mon histoire, comment est-ce qu'à 21 ans, j'ai pu devenir bilingue grâce à trois conseils assez simples que j'ai mis en pratique au quotidien et qui m'ont aidé à vraiment améliorer mon niveau d'anglais. Et je crois que ces conseils, tels qu'ils m'ont aidé, ils pourront aussi vous aider, et c'est mon souhait pour vous. Donc tout de suite, allons-y pour le conseil numéro 1. Give you the first tip is to have a real motive, like something that you really want to reach, and that will help you master the thing. It can be, for example, that you want to read some books, because let's be honest, in English you will have the best authors, the best literature. English is the key. If you don't know how to speak English, you are hiding yourself so many tools in order to have a better life. All coachings, development, personal development, classes, you know, so many things are in English. So when you are not speaking English, you are just... But it's really important. So first of all, find a reason, a core. Maybe it can be like me, if you find an American boy. Is consistency difficult? Yes, but there are some tools that will help you be consistent, but with fun. For example, I used Duolingo. This app is absolutely a miracle. I use it like every day. I had 15 minutes. You can make a program and you have 15 minutes every day. And in English, consistency is better than intensity. Sometimes we are like, for 1 week, we can do 2 hours in English and we are like, okay, now I'm gonna master it. No, the key is to be consistent. Donc nous voici aux États-Unis. No, I'm joking. We still be in France, because for immersion, you don't need to go far away, like to go to United States, England. No, the first thing that you can do that is really easy is to put your phone in English. That's the thing we don't think about, but we have our phone every day, every time. So why don't we just put it in English, so we are in this English context? And the second thing is the imitation technique. This technique, I learned it through the classes of Emma from English, and she told us that if we want to speak like native people, we just need to imitate them. So find someone that you really like the accent and you just want to copy the same. So for me, it was Melody Alisa. This woman is just a blessing for me. I really enjoy her channel. And when I look at her speaking, I'm just imitating the same thing, the same moves, the same tone of the voice, the same accent. And that's the best way for us to learn and to grow. So find someone and speak like this person. That's your challenge for today. You all need to find an English person that you really like the accent, the way she speaks, the style even, and you can just copy. And that will be the best way to improve your English. So that's all for our third technique. Merci de nous avoir suivis. Mais avant de partir, comme pour toutes les vidéos, on aura à chaque fois un petit moment Your Turn. Et le principe, c'est qu'en fait, c'est à votre tour de mettre une action en œuvre pour pouvoir progresser en anglais. Et l'action d'aujourd'hui, c'est de me dire en commentaire, qu'est-ce que pour vous ça va changer, le fait de pouvoir parler couramment anglais? Qu'est-ce que ça va changer dans votre quotidien?
Moi, je mettrai également ce que ça a changé pour moi au quotidien. Et vous pouvez mettre, je ne sais pas, peut-être dans votre carrière professionnelle, vous aurez beaucoup plus d'opportunités. Peut-être ça vous permet de rencontrer l'amour de votre vie parce qu'il parle anglais. Ou peut-être, je ne sais pas, à vous de me dire. Et ça permettra à d'autres d'être motivés. On se motivera tous ensemble. Et donc, c'est le but un peu de Your Turn. Donc, merci de répondre aux commentaires. Et n'hésitez pas à suivre la prochaine vidéo. Salut!